Any other activities you guys want to do?
Not for me.
Cool. Next day rolls around. Did you guys head down to the... you've already spoke with the captain. He's like, yeah, we're leaving on the next day. Everything's according to plan. You go down. And
I tell him about the horses, too, by the way.
Are you telling about the horses? No horses?
No horses.
All right, good, good. So 45 ahead, then.
That's the price, sir.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of you. So 40 times 5 is...
220, right?
225, I think you mean.
Damn it. 270. Yeah. No, it's a 2...
5 times 5 is 25, he says. 5 times 4 is 20.
You guys are...
Out of 0 for the 40, and then you have the 25, it's 225.
I am terrible at math, yes.
It's okay. It is 225. Because I can type.
So just
45.
Everyone take off 45 gold, I guess.
Yeah.
God.
Are the beggars there as we're walking on? Neil?
The beggars? Yes, there are tons of beggars. Beggar children. It's actually flooded with them. There's like 60 of them.
Okay. I wink to Largo and just say, act entertaining. I say to the rest of the crowd, this could perhaps get us a discount on the ship.
So I look around for the captain.
Okay, you find him.
Is he kind of watching the scene with the children and myself there?
Yeah, he is looking at all this, going, what the hell's going on?
I look back to him and I'm like, we're famous, don't you know that? And then I do a little song and dance for the kids.
Do you want to do a song and dance for us, or do you just want to roll a die?
We'll just roll the dice on this.
Okay. Side.
But you could get the bonus, Ryan. You
could get a bonus, Ryan.
Oh, that plus 5, though. What do I roll, Neil?
D20 plus... just give me a charisma check.
Okay. Even with the bonus, I think it wouldn't...
plus 5. Wow, that would have brought you right to a 20, wouldn't it? The kids are not entertained, and they start booing and jeering at you.
Say now, friends, please, it's a...
You're not the real performers! They're fakes! Yeah.
Come on, Smee.
I say, come friends, on, he's having an off day. Captain, would you allow us to... Would you like to be part of a performance?
No.
Great.
Sing, Smee! Sing, Smee!
I turn to the crowd, I'm just like... ladies and gentlemen, it is early in the morning. We bid you all a farewell, and when we come by town, we will make sure to bring the entire circus with us.
Boo!
Come on, Smee!
Quickly, get onto the ship! They're riding!
All right, guys, all board up and head out.
I could have busted out some Rastafarian dance moves.
When we get on the ship, I'm just like, Jesus, this place... It's worse than Redditvania.
Redditvania.
Oh, it's so going to be a town.
It is. The natural weapon is, or the common weapon is a pitchfork. And we start sailing, Neil.
Yeah, I just am slightly confused by... Never mind. So, you guys take off on your ship. The journey to Varkas is going to be a long one. It's going to be like 2 weeks at sea. He's going to make a couple of stops in other towns along the way, you know, to unload good, to unload passengers and that sort of thing. So it's going to be a total of a 2-week journey. You will stop at Puerto Mayorta, Island View,
what the shit?
Cape Flotsam, and Sea View.
Wait, do they speak Spanish? Or sorry, Thieves Cant in...
No.
Okay.
I mean, there's probably some thieves there that no thieves can't, but okay. It's, you know, its own place.
I also like Forchanistan. I think that's a good one as well.
Is that there?
No, it's not there.
That's just a suggestion from the chat. I thought that I should say that.
The first city to have a number in it.
Yeah.
You don't.
Kraken Bay sounds fun. You sure we don't want to go there?
Kraken Bay. we roll up and it's like, I'm a Kraken. He's just like snapping. Fuck this town. We're never coming here again.
So a few days pass, and you stop off at Herto Mivorta, and it's a pretty boring stop. You know, you can go to, you can spend the night at an inn if you want to sleep in dry land. You can go, you know, do normal things in a town. It's a small town. Or you can just stay on the ship, whatever you want.
Probably, since we're all not seafaring people, at least for myself, I'm excited to get off and, enjoy dry dock for a while, or dry land, rather.
Okay. Most of you guys?
I would like to go out into the city, mm-hmm. and the whole time I'm there, I'm going to be walking around like a normal person, but I'm going to be scouring the city for marks.
Okay. And what are you going to do when you find your mark?
I'm going to just take note of them, and then I want an hour before we depart for you to just let me know, Neal, and then I'll continue.
Okay. An hour before you depart would be like the break of dawn.
Okay. Before people usually go to bed, then.
Okay. It's time before they go to bed right now.
Okay. I would like to steal from a mark.
All right. Okay, give me a pickpockets check. Oh, do you get a 57? All right, no problem.
Keep in mind, I've been like looking all day for
yeah.
or however long you've been there. So
yeah. Well done. You get 13 gold.
Sick. Okay, I'll go back to the ship right after that.
Okay. Yeah, everything goes accordingly. You're not caught or anything. And you guys all make it back to the ship together.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. We set sail the next day. Do we see what the captain's bringing on board, or is it just boxes and stuff?
It's mostly crates of food stuffs. In one town, you pick up a bunch of apples and oranges and shit. You load it off in the next town. Right in this town, he's unloading those apples and oranges and stuff, and he's picking up a crate of spears and then some specialty foods that are supposed to be usable for blah blah. He doesn't really explain it too much to you. He's like, specialty foods for strange creatures here and there. And some guy asked me to move this crate. I don't know what the fuck's in it. It's just sealed up, so we're just taking the crate.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just selling. Not much is happening.
I take my protecting job serious, so I am wearing my half skull mask and I'm walking up and down the ship and knocking on things and pointing at random things and kind of looking around and nodding approvingly on a pretty regular basis.
Okay. So you arrive the next day while you're out at sea, kind of just sailing about. The waters are, you know, dark and turbulent as always. And it's pretty normal. This is a fairly large ship. It has a crew of 45, and most of them are rowers, so they'll row all day. There's no sails on the ship. It's just oar-powered.
Neal, do we hear any songs, perhaps chanted?
Yes, there is a drummer who is downstairs where the rowers are, and he pounds on the drums all day to, like, give people, you know,
okay.
something to row to. But yeah,
I think on my flute.
Yeah,
I think
that's
my flute.
Back then. You play.
I know, but it's a funny way to put that. Is
I practice my flute abilities, Neal.
You're terrible.
Yeah, but
practice makes perfect.
If I practice it enough, will I get a small proficiency in fluting?
If you choose it as your next non-weapon proficiency, yes.
Oh. You can't just learn stuff.
Yeah, like. You cannot learn.
In the Nealiverse, nobody learns. You're only like, it's like the Matrix. You have to be programmed with it. Like, he has to download it.
Rules as written say you only gain non-weapon proficiencies at certain levels. But if you're actually put a lot of effort into this, and continue with it and stick with it and keep saying that you keep practicing over and over again, I might let you learn something outside of your normal proficiency level up. But, you know, you actually have to put effort into it.
Yeah, I'm practicing flute.
Okay. You can't auto-cast practice is what I'm trying to say.
If you put a lot of work into it, you'll learn it.
Every time.
Okay, I'm going to keep practicing the flute.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, practicing flute.
Okay. Anyway, you guys are hanging out. There are two other passengers this time. One of them is a priest of Vrassi, who is with you guys. And another one is just some rich merchant who's here with his goods. It's the unknown crate.
Does the priest have guards with him?
No, he has no guards.
I spend most of the trip convincing him that God doesn't exist.
Vrassi doesn't exist?
That Vrassi doesn't, yeah, and the religion is a hack. The entire ship, right? How does he take that now?
When you say, so how do you do this? Like, give me your approach.
I just walk up to him and I'm just like, so you're a priest, huh?
I'm a priest of the great and powerful Vrassi. You had best beware, little man.
Beware of what exactly?
Beware of my powers.
What are your powers exactly? And I'm saying this all very condescendingly.
You do not dare to snub me, do you?
Well, if you were a great and powerful priest, you would have guards with you, would you not?
I do not need guards, nor did I say I was great and powerful.
You just said I should be fearful of you.
You are too brash.
I just give him a weird look. I'm like, huh? I thought you had to be smart to be in the priesthood.
He reaches down and grabs you by the collar and says, say one more word, Munchkin. Say it. I dare you.
I just smile at him. I don't say anything.
That's what I thought.
Then I walk off.
Okay.
So much for telling him there's no God, JP.
Oh, I'm not. The ship's... We're just getting started. The night is young. I almost said one more word, but then I didn't do it.
Okay, do you continue to fuck with him throughout the... Are you going to screw with him more? And if so, when will you continue screwing with him?
How close are we? Like, how long are we in the trip, in the journey?
I mean, that was an hour into the journey, and it will take another day and a half to get to the next town.
Oh, I wait till we leave the next town.
Okay, cool. So before you get to the next town, you guys are sailing along dark and turbulent waters. It is the afternoon. Sun is up, kind of bright day. Captain is commenting on how, oh, we've had such lovely weather. The tide's been with us the whole way. Quite unusual.
It's in the background, you can hear the flute. Beep, beep.
Yeah. And you are all completely taken unawares by these all grappling hooks start like flying out of the water and attaching to the side of the ship, up and down the sides.
Arm yourselves!
Looks around to both sides and goes, what the fuck's going on? Man! And starts shouting downstairs, to arms! To arms!
I rip my red... No, I'm better with a spear, right?
Yes.
I pull my spear off my back and throw my shield and go to the hooks.
All right.
Neil, I climb the one of the sails.
There's no sails.
What? It's a rowboat? Oh, it's a rowboat?
Row-powered.
Yeah, but they have to have some sails. There's no thing to use wind at all in any way, shape, or form.
No, this is a ship that is powered entirely by man.
So it's just a completely flat ship.
I mean, you got a forecastle and an aft castle, but yeah, you don't have any masts.
Okay, never mind.
Yeah, no some ship
exists like that.
Neil, I'm not even like, I'm plunging my spear down at the closest thing that I can.
Okay, and...
I'm going to take out my boat.
If I'm not mistaken, you normally carry, you normally wear your armor with you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Especially as head of security, Neil.
Head of security, you are armored at all points in time. Don't fall in the water.
Can I quickly... Oh, wait, never mind. No masks, I forgot. I take up arms.
You take up arms. Everyone takes
I get my weapon.
Yeah, I got my bow.
Make sure my armor and everything is on me. Because it would be. I don't know why it wouldn't be.
All right. And I think at this point we should roll for initiative unless, JP, this is break time.
No, we've got like 10, 15 minutes. And if it goes to an hour 30, that's fine. We'll just do an hour 30 break.
I don't get an attack before initiative?
Yeah. I mean, you declared... Yeah, I will let you go swipe up these suckers before initiative.
But you want to roll anyways for after that?
So D6.
Nine.
You take a swing at the...
That's a D10, not a D20.
Yeah, I rolled D10.
Rolling for initiative.
Oh, okay.
I also said I wanted to take out my bow before we talked about
initiative. Yeah, you take out your bow. No problem.
Me and Ryan didn't say anything.
Two. Victarion, you're slashing at the grappling hooks themselves?
No, the guy is coming up the grappling hooks.
Okay, yeah, they haven't gotten to the top yet. They're still coming up.
Then what I would do is, I look over. Is it a bunch of guys climbing over?
It's a greenish, it's like a 6-foot fish with hands and legs, carrying a trident and a net over its back. It looks something like...
Of course it is.
Except for
Frogman. Okay. If they're not within range of the spear... Can I take a free action of unhooking one of the hooks, or is it really well in?
I mean, you'll have to make like a strength check, but yeah, I'll let you do that instead.
I'll do that then. So D20 plus my 16.
Yes, sir.
24.
Oh, just one shy. Just one shy. I need a 25 for that one.
Seriously?
You're pulling up this hook, and you pull down, and as you go up to lift it up, I mean, the weight of the fish is that weight of a normal person. Like,
oh, right, yeah.
Fish, so you're like, oh, what the fuck? And it gets stuck. And then at that point, the fish is, like, crawling over the side. And so initiative rolls. You two already have yours. Largo,
could I have shot the creature with my bow, or is that impossible?
No, he wasn't over the side until just now.
Okay, then since I was ready, can I hold action, and then as soon as he gets up, I shoot him?
That requires a bow specialty, by definition. The specialized really? With a bow, if they have their bow notched and drawn, can make an attack before combat starts.
Neal,
the benefits you get by specializing with the bow. So to give it to you right now would to decrease any point in it would decrease the coolness of a bow specialization.
I have a random question. As somebody with a bow specialization, can I stand back and wait, and then as soon as he climbs overboard and I see him, can I shoot him?
If you were a fighter and could specialize with a bow, then yes.
I'm specialized with a short bow.
No, you're not. You're proficient. You're proficient.
Oh, God. Well, there goes that joke. I just sound stupid now. Okay, never mind.
The effort was there, though. I liked it.
I want to run to the edge of the ship, point my bow over, looking down one of the hooks, and shoot straight down.
Okay. And
yeah, I'll do the same. I'll go to a corner with the bow and be ready to shoot when he gets on.
So you're doing something very different.
Very similar.
Tomato, tomato. Just shooting over the edge. You're just looking until someone comes up on top. So he's approaching them and leaning over the ship. You're staying way back in the middle of the ship or at the back of the ship.
Yeah.
22 is my roll.
We actually need an initiative roll out of you.
If you guys could do that a hell of a lot faster, that'd be great.
8.
Plus 7.
15.
There we go. Smee, what are you doing?
I'm getting up next to the where they're coming up.
Getting it up?
Yeah, okay. with the grappling hooks, putting my back next to it and trying to hide in shadows to the best I can.
Okay.
Which is 95%. I just don't know if there's a proper blend of shadow and light.
Yeah, there's a proper blend of shadow. Give me a hide in shadows check.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And weapon speed of a trident is in the other book.
And then I'm just waiting.
I'm just going to roll all of their initiatives on the same initiative thing because there's too many to bother rolling separately.
How many are there?
You're not sure yet, but I'll let you know as soon as you know.
How many grappling hooks do we see?
I looked over the edge and I got so bedazzled by the one that I just lost track of.
Jeff, when you look over the edge,
what
the
did
light
I see when I looked over
bounces
the side?
Off the side.
When you looked over the side, you see about a dozen ropes on that side of the ship. There are more ropes on the other side. And each of those ropes had a fish guy on it, but that doesn't mean that's all there is. So you saw at least a dozen.
Okay.
Okay, so you guys have, who's got better than a 9?
Oh, did I roll? Nah, I got 12.
12. Victarion got a 9. So you go at the same time as one of the fish guys, Victarion.
Okay.
So the fish guys from one side, the fish guys from both sides all climb on top, and that's pretty much their action for this round.
So I'm +4 as an adjust, and then do I get a +1 from something else?
Your melee adjust is +4 because you're fifth level. Right. Then you get +1 for specialization.
So I'm at normally 25, and they're above now, so I don't get any advantage for height or high ground or anything. Okay, so just 20, so +5.
Yes.
So one of them hops over. I'm kind of like backpedaling away from the railing then, as my yank attempt didn't work.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to stab towards the chest for 19.
Do it.
I did. 19.
19 is a hit on the fish man. Give me your...
We actually haven't fought in like 3 weeks, so is it D8 plus...
It's medium size, so D6, I think, for a spear?
Right.
Yeah. D6 plus what? 1 for strength, 2 for specialization, so D6 plus 3?
I didn't get anything for level 5 or something like that?
No, there's no damage bonus.
Am I level 6 now?
Are you level
6?
He is 6, yes.
Yeah, I'm level 6.
Okay, so it should be plus 5 to hit, so plus 6 to hit, including specialization. So that should be a 20 instead of 19, which is still not a crit because it wasn't natural, blah, blah, blah. So I think it's just D6 plus 3 damage for you.
I thought it's, let me check the sheet. I thought it was plus 4.
2 for... Wait, no, you're level 6.
Yeah, that's what I just... We just agreed on that.
That was slipped. Okay. So, no, then in which case you get plus 3 to hit for specialization and plus 3 to damage. So it should be plus 5, plus 8, plus... So plus 8 to hit total and plus 3 on damage. So that should be...
That's 22 now.
Yeah. It still doesn't clear by 10.
Okay.
But D6 plus 3 damage. So D6 plus 4 damage. I'm sorry.
4. There we go. So it takes 9 damage.
9 damage. The fishman falls to his death on board, giving out a... the other fishmen all climb up, and there's now about 15 or 20 of them on the deck.
Are there guards from the captain here?
His men are below decks, gathering their weapons and running up.
Okay.
Rest of the party. Smee, you went at 10?
Yes. Is the one that climbed up in front of me, is its back to me? Is that hidden shadows so he didn't see me?
His side is to you. He's like climbed up and was looking about. You're kind of stuck behind a barrel peering out around the corner.
Can I wait till his back is to me or can I move?
Yeah, you can delay your turn until he...
Yeah, I'm just going to delay till his back's to me.
Okay. Yeah, after Jen goes, then you can go.
Cool.
Jockery?
Yeah, I'm going to shoot my bow at like the closest one to me.
Okay, roll to hit.
Roll D20 plus 2, right, Neil?
Yeah.
It's D20 plus 2. Oh, what the? Damn it. Never mind.
What level are you, Jockery?
Level 6.
Should be plus 3, right?
Should be plus 3.
Still fails. Oh, no, I'm level 5?
You're level 5? How are you level 5 if Jeff is level 6?
Well, I don't know.
We've
got 22,614 XP.
Yeah?
I think you hit 6 at 22, or at 2,000.
I might be level 6.
If we're at 22, Jeff is level 5, not level 6.
Yeah. I cheated. Not on purpose, though. You're right. It's level 5.
Okay.
We haven't fought in literally a month, guys, so I do apologize. That's not come up.
I'm just checking.
You still kill that fish? Yeah.
I was looking for where it says level, and there it is. Plain as day. Level 5.
I just like the... Yeah, I cheated, guys.
Yeah, I cheated.
He was dead, though. Like,
yeah, he was dead. Yeah. So you're level 5, Jen, which is Level 2, you get plus 1. At level 3, you get 1, 2, 3. So, no, it's at 3 and 4. So you're actually at plus 2 right now.
Okay.
Yeah. So you miss with your first shot. You get a second shot at the end of the round.
Nice.
At this point, the fishman is turned and is like croaking to his fellow fishman next to him.
So plus two for surprise.
Yeah. So plus 4 for surprise back attack total.
Yep, I back attack him for 17.
Hit.
Okay, and I'm level 5 now as a thief, so that's 3d.
Three. Yeah, it's triple damage. So.
Okay.
Or double. Yeah.
From all ones.
I don't think I get any plus damage. 15 strength. Thief fighter. Do I get any for a multi-class?
No. No.
Okay. 14.
Look at that beautiful damage. Yeah. You slaughter the shit out of that fish. Okay. You just stab your back right through it.
Yeah, I run him through and then try to remove it as possible to hide in shadows again.
Fish slumps to the ground and topples over the side of the ship.
I scurry off and try to hide in shadows with Move Silently as well before someone notices me.
Oh no, the fish that he was talking to totally. Okay. I mean, his friend just like collapsed with the knife through his belly.
Sure.
So no, there was a long sword through him.
What? Right? I have a bastard sword.
A bastard sword, yeah, same thing. Most of them. Yeah, Smee. Or Largo. There you go.
Yeah, I just want to shoot one of the frogmen in the face that's come over the edge.
Fishman. Come on.
Fishman, sorry.
Thanks.
Can my roll stand from last time, or do I have to roll
again? No, roll.
Okay. 23.
Aren't you happy you re-rolled?
It's even better.
You critical a fish.
Excellent.
So 2d6?
Yeah, I think so. 8.
He takes the arrow to the chest and stumbles around, but does not fall to the ground.
Nice.
Yeah.
You critical for just 2d6? Yeah, I guess so.
He actually needs to make a save versus death, which he fails. Give me a d10 for location and a 2d4 for severity.
Whoa.
I don't know if that's actually going to do anything.
It's max severity.
No, it's not.
Oh, no, it's not. Never mind.
Piercing versus humanoid. Piercing versus humanoid. Location 5. Severity 4. Abdomen grazed, minor bleeding. Most useless thing ever.
That major bleeding, that'll fucking get you.
Major severe bleeding will fucking get you. That's the
what is minor bleeding again?
Every 10 rounds, you take 1 to 2 hit points.
Oh, God, never mind.
So yep. Is it on the 10th round, or does it go 1 and then 11?
No, on the 10th round. Yeah. Jen, you get your second attack, and Largo, get your second attack.
18.
Hit.
I don't know my damage.
Are you taking a fresh one or D6. The injured?
Longbow D8 damage. Holy shit.
D8 longbow.
Yes. Using a longbow?
Yep.
Do you have a proficiency with that?
Yep.
Okay. Cool.
6.
You hit your guy for 6 damage.
Yes.
Neal,
pew.
I forget. The reason that I took fighter as a dual class was because I get 2 attacks a round or every other round?
Every other round.
Okay.
Yeah. And Lord goes second shot.
Yep.
Seeing the one that I already hit is quite injured, I'm going to go for a fresh one.
Fresh one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just to menace, like, threaten him with a shot of an arrow. I'm not going to actually try and hit him.
Yeah, of course. You just want to get him off his guard. So he's
you roll for psychological damage to it, Neal?
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah, he totally fails his willpower check. You see a yellow fluid running down the side of his leg.
Awesome.
They do pee yellow. Interesting.
I call Bear Grylls in.
He's sort of off leg.
I'm sorry, you left him tied to a tree. He can't get anywhere.
True story. Too many inside jokes. Let's fucking move on.
Initiative round.
I'll roll for it.
Nope. Are we doing group initiative?
First, right.
Initiative.
I'll roll.
Nice.
Ten. There's that one.
Woo!
We're missing one. No, Largo, you got a 15. Okay, sorry. Smee, you are first, my friend.
Are any of them surprised if I go to attack them? Or are any of them have their back to me? I would argue that the people behind me on the boat saw me, but the people in front of me, perhaps the one that's facing Victorian after they were attacked, have their back to me.
Oh my god, people asking for back attacks are so annoying.
But I at least
can't you visualize?
I at least lawyered it instead of saying
there were a few times, Dan, where it's pretty funny that we'd be like fighting a dragon and it clearly sees us and you're like, well, can I get a sneak attack? It's like, no.
I am,
and then a train drove by.
Yeah, a train drove by. That's the sound of the wind going by everyone.
It's a windy day at sea.
Yeah.
All right. Now here's our much larger ship than the last ship. It's totally different. It's not the same ship reconfigured at all.
I bet you there's two balls at the end of this. Oh, nope. Never mind. We lied.
Here. Oh, yeah.
That looks like a nice propeller.
Is this like perhaps like 5.5 football fields long, Neil? Is that accurate?
Five football fields?
I couldn't do feet because that doesn't make any sense. Maybe it's just a gigantic boat, Neil. I don't know.
5 football fields? Holy shit.
It's a Viking ship. You never know. They made some big ships.
Well, let's just say it's stiff as wood.
okay, we did.